الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين أحمده سبحانه وأشكره ومن مساوي عملي أستغفره وأستعينه على نيل رضا وأستمد لطفه فيما قضى وبعد إني باليقين أشهد شهادة الإخلاص ألا يعبد بالحق مألوه سوى الرحمن من جل عن عيب وعن نقصان وأن خير خلقه محمد من جاءنا بالبينات والهدى رسوله إلى جميع الخلق بالنور والهدى ودين الحق صلى عليه ربنا ومجد والآل والصحب دوما صرمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد سلام من الله عليكم ورحمته وبركاته After praising Allah Azza wa Jal and sending salutations upon our messenger Muhammad alayhi salatu salam and proceed. And alhamdulillah that Allah Azza wa Jal has allowed us to come to this gathering. A gathering that we're remembering Allah Jalla fi ulahin. A gathering that Allah Azza wa Jal's mercy descends upon. And His tranquility. And His angels, they surround these gatherings. And Allah Azza wa Jal, those who sit in these gatherings, He remembers it in heavens. And He's the one who says Jalla fi ulah. فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ وَاشْكُرُونِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ Remember me, and I'll definitely remember you, Allah says. And be grateful to me, and do not be ungrateful. And Allah Azza wa Jalla notice here, He mentions dhikr, His remembrance, and shukr, gratitude, together in the same ayah, indicating that showing gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jalla It is through worshipping Allah and remembering Allah and increasing your ibadah. So glad tidings to you. Alhamdulillah, today we are speaking about the greatest speech. Kalam Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, speech of Allah, Al-Quran. This speech, this book that Allah Azza wa Jalla sent to us as guidance for us, as a mercy for us. As a cure for us, as a light, a spirit, and so on. Allah Azza wa Jalla describes it. In it is our might, in it is our honor. وَكَذَٰلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانُ ولكن جعلناه نورا نهدي به من نشاء من عبادنا وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم وقال الله تبارك وتعالى كتاب أنزلناه إليك لتخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور بإذن ربهم إلى صراط العزيز الحميد وقال الله تبارك وتعالى كتاب أنزلناه إليك مبارك ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب وقال عز من قائل سبحانه أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا وقال تعالى أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها وقال سبحانه فلا أقسم بمواقع النجوم وإنه لقسم لو تعلمون عظيم إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون وقال سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الناس يا أيها الناس قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور وهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون وقال سبحانه وتعالى وقل جاء الحق وزهق الباطل إن الباطل كان زهوقا وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين ولا يزيد الظالمين إلا خسارا وقال سبحانه وتعالى لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد قرآن That's enough of a lecture, huh? Right? I don't say anything. I heard the speech of Allah. We can go on and on and recite the whole Quran, huh? What do you think? Kalamullahi, the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal, it addresses the heart, it penetrates the heart, even if you don't understand it. It's from out of this world. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal, he says of this Quran, it is a shifa, it is a cure. It's a cure for all of the illnesses of the heart. And it cures the greatest matter, which is disbelief. Huh? So that you come to Iman and belief. Allah Azza wa Jalla says the Quran is Nur, light. It will be Nur for you, light for you in this dunya. And it will be light for you in your grave. And it will be light for you in the Akhirah. What is dark? Kalamullahi tabarak wa ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jalla told us that He revealed it so that we understand it and act upon it. That's the objective. Reciting it is not the objective, it's the means to get to the objective. So that we, our hearts are affected. And that encourages us and pushes us to act upon the Quran. Because as we recited, Allah says, Kitabun anzalnahu ilayka mubarakun liyadabbaru ayatihi wa liyatadakkara ulul albab. A book that we have revealed to you, Muhammad alayhi salatu salam, which is blessed. Why has it been revealed? So that they reflect and ponder upon its ayat, its verses. And so that those who have understanding and intellect can remember. When they remember, they act. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Do they not reflect upon the Qur'an? أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Or are they locks upon their hearts? Who is this ayah referring to? Huh? Who's referring to this ayah? Allah says, do they not reflect upon the Qur'an? Or are they locks upon their hearts? Who's this talking about? Who has locks upon their hearts? Huh? The disbelievers are type of disbelievers, not all the disbelievers. Allah is referring to a specific type of them. Huh? The hypocrites, the munafiqeen, Allah is referring to. Basically, Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying here that if there weren't locks on the hearts of the hypocrites, they would also be able to reflect upon the Quran. So what about the believer who believes in the Quran? He no doubt can reflect upon the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla because he has Iman. And that's the first thing you require in order to understand the Quran properly, for the Quran to benefit you. Like Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Verily the believers are those when Allah is mentioned, their hearts tremble. And when the ayat, the verses of Allah Azza wa Jal, are recited to them, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, it increases them in iman. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, and upon their Lord they have reliance and trust. Just by hearing the believer, just by hearing the Qur'an, it increases iman. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jal, He says in the Qur'an, another ayah indicating that our iman, it increases. هو الذي أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم ولله جنود السماوات والأرض وكان الله عزيزا حكيما. هو الذي الله أنزل, He revealed, He put sakina, tranquility in the hearts of the believers. What will happen? ليزدادوا, so that they can increase in the iman, with the iman they already have. These gatherings, that's what they do. Hearing the book of Allah, reciting the book of Allah. Rather, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَن تَبُورَ لِيُوَفِّيَهُمْ أُجُورَهُمْ وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. إنه غفور شكور. إن الذين يتلون كتاب الله. Verily those who recite the book of Allah, they don't only recite it, but they follow it. Tilawa also means following it. And what else they do? وَقَامُ الصَّلَاةِ. And they establish a prayer. And they perfect it. They do qam of salah. That's by default. If a person is a person of the Quran, no doubt that the ibadah will be on point.
وَقَامُ الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُ.
And they give, Allah says, whatever we have given them, for the sake of Allah and charity. In secret and in public. What are they hoping for? يَرْجُونَ. They are hoping, Allah says,
يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَّن تَبُورَ.
They are hoping and they are seeking a trade, a business with Allah that will never perish. The Akhirah. Then Allah says,
لِيُوَفِّيَهُمْ أُجُورَهُمْ وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ.
لِيُوَفِّيَهُمْ أُجُورَهُمْ. Allah will grant them their reward. And وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And Allah will increase them in His bounties. He will increase them in His bounties, blessings. These are the people of the Quran. That's what they get. When you hold up to the book of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, that's what you get. But on top of that, Allah Azza wa Jalla tells you, these people who are people of the Quran, Allah says,
ثُمَّ أَوْرَثْنَا الْكِتَابَ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَيْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا فَمِنْهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدٌ وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَضْلُ الْكَبِيرُ.
Allah says, ثُمَّ أَوْرَثَنَا. Then we granted the book, Al-Kitaba. الَّذِينَ ذَوْزِ اصْطَفَيْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. That we have chosen from our slaves. And those who are granted the Qur'an, Allah Azza wa Jalla has chosen them. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us that the believers, generally all of them, they are the best.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ.
Allah says, verily those who believe and do righteous deeds, verily they are the best of creation. So all the believers are the best. Amongst the believers are those who are even better. The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said,
خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ.
The best of you are those who learn the Qur'an and teach it. يعني the best of the best.
وَذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ.
And that's a blessing that Allah grants to whoever He wishes. And that's what the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he says. Or Abu al-Umama al-Bahili radiallahu anhu narrates, وَحُكْمُهُ الْمَرْفُوعِ. And in the hadith, it has the hukm marfu', as if the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said it.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُعَذِّبُ قَلْبًا وَعَى الْقُرْآنَ.
Allah Azza wa Jalla will not punish a heart that contains the Qur'an.
Subhanallah.
Allah Jalla fi ulah will not punish a heart that contains the Qur'an. Wi'a in the Arabic language means a container. So what does this mean? Wa'a al-Qur'an. It means that the individual has memorized it. He understands it. He acts upon it. That is the heart containing the Qur'an. Not just only memorizing it. That's not sufficient. Memorizing it, acting upon it, understanding it, reflecting upon it. All of this is the heart containing the Qur'an. It loves the Qur'an more than everything else. It's the food of the soul. When it recites the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla, it feels contentment in the heart. Because it's a remembrance of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, the best form of remembrance. And Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us that in His remembrance you find tranquility and contentment and happiness.
الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا
وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات طوبى لهم وحسن مآب.
Allah says, الذين آمنوا, those who believe, and their hearts, they find tranquility and rest in the remembrance of Allah. Verily, only the remembrance of Allah Azza to the hearts find tranquility and rest. And Allah says, الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات. Verily, those who believe and do righteous deeds, طوبى لهم وحسن مآب. For them is طوبى. The ulama, they say طوبى is a tree in Jannah. وحسن مآب. And a good abode, and a Jannah. They go home to. The Quran, if you live by the Quran, and you follow the Quran, and you learn the Quran, it is an easy way to Jannah. Because the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he says, مَنْ قَرَأَ حَرْفَ مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ فَلَهُ بِهِ حَسَنَةٌ وَالْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا لَا أَقُولُ أَلِفْ لَا مِنْ حَرْفْ بَلْ أَلِفٌ حَرْفْ وَلَا مُنْ حَرْفْ وَمِنْ حَرْفْ. He said, صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم, whoever recites a harf from the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, he will get, because of that harf, a hasana. And the hasana bi'ashri amthali is equivalent to 10 hasana. And he said, لا أقول ألف لا ميم حرف. But ألف is a harf, and lam is a harf, and ميم is a harf. So for ألف لا ميم, how much are you getting? Huh? 30? Are you sure? Huh? 30? 100%? Bismillah. طيب. You get 30 with the opinion that harf means letter. But some of the ulama say harf does not mean letter. Harf means a sound. Harf means, so alif now. Alif is made up of alif, lam, fa. Lam is made up of lam, alif, meem. Meem is made up of meem, ya, meem. So how many letters do you have there? 9. So of alif, lam, meem, you're getting 90, they say the ulama, some of them. And guess what? وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He multiplies for whoever He wishes. And the hadith says 700 folds. Minimum. And the minimum is 30 or 90, let's say. And Allah Azza multiplies for whoever He wishes. طيب. With the opinion that for Alif Lam Mim, you're getting 30. Okay? If I complete the Quran once, how much reward am I getting? Huh? Where's the mathematicians? Huh? How much reward am I getting for the whole Quran, one completion of the Quran? If Alif Lam Mim is 130. Does anyone know how many letters in the Quran? Anyone know? The minimum that you get for completing the whole Quran, minimum this is, 3 million and something rewards. And that's minimum. And then we have وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. And Allah multiplies for whatever He wishes. You can get trillions if you want it. Master, رَحْمَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Easy road. If I recite, huh? That doesn't mean that you have to know a lot of Quran, by the way. If you memorize a little bit of Quran, huh? And you just repeat that little bit of Quran that you have recited, that you know, you still get the reward. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said to the Sahaba, أَلَا أُعَلِّمُكُمْ ثُلَثَ الْقُرْآنِ, shall I not teach you the third of the Qur'an? The Sahaba said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. He said, Surah Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ, it's a third of the Qur'an. طيب, if I recite قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ 3 times, it's like I recite the whole Qur'an. The ulama, they say that if you recite قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ 3 times, you get the reward of reciting the whole Qur'an. Allahu Akbar. Look, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ 3 times is hard. Okay, let's do it now. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدٍ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدٍ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ
ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. ما شاء الله, we finished the Quran.
Easy? Look how easy it is. These rewards, the rewards of Allah Azza wa Jalla, He's made it easy for us to attain. But we have to utilize it. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he also says,
من قرأ سورة الإخلاص عشر مرات بنى الله له بيتا في الجنة. Whoever recites Surah Ikhlas 10 times, Allah Azza wa Jalla build him a palace in Jannah. Allahu Akbar.
You see, easy reward.
Yani, Surah Ikhlas, every single one of us has memorized it. Yalla, you recite it 3 times every day. You recite it as many times as you can. You get the reward that is great.
There was a Sahabi. He used to lead a group of Sahaba in Medina in Salah. And every time you lead them in Salah, he recites Surah Ikhlas. So this Sahaba, they came to the Prophet ﷺ, Ya Rasulullah. This Sahaba, it's Imam. He always recites Surah Ikhlas, Qul Huwallahu Ahad. He doesn't let us hear any other Quran. Qul Huwallahu Ahad, Qul Huwallahu Ahad, every day. Why, Ya Rasulullah, we're complaining to you about this man. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said, call him, Yalla. Bring him here. He said to him, what's wrong with you, Ya Shaykh? Why are you reciting Qul Huwallahu Ahad? He said, Ya Rasulullah, inni uhibbuha. He said, I love it. The Prophet ﷺ said to him, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّكَ كَمَا تُحِبُّهَا. He said, just like you love it, know that Allah loves you.
Subhanallah.
Why? Because in Surah Ikhlas, it's sifatullah, the attributes of Allah. And he loves talking about Allah. So just like you love talking about Allah and remembering Allah constantly, Allah loves you. Allahu Akbar. Quran. It's the easiest way of attaining the love of Allah, the reward of Allah, the Jannah of Allah, palaces in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. The Messenger alayhi salatu salam, he also tells Al-Mahiru bil-Qur'an ma'a safarati al-kiram al-barara. The one who recites the Qur'an proficiently, well, he will be with the angels yawm al-qiyamah. And then he said, وَالَّذِي يَقْرَأُ الْقُرْآنِ وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ شَاقْ وَيَفَتَعْتَعْ بِالْقُرْآنِ فَلَهُ أَجْرًا. He said, and the one who recites the Qur'an and he finds it difficult and he's stuttering, etc., he has two rewards. Even if you can't recite the Qur'an properly, you get double the reward, the one who recited it properly. Subhanallah. You get the reward for each letter and you get the reward for the effort. Subhanallah. So no one has excuse. If you're struggling, if you make mistakes, Allah Azza wa Jalla overlook your mistakes. As long as you're trying, but rather he'll reward you for your mistakes. Allahu Akbar. Rather, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he tells us that, oh, Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran,
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
If the Quran is recited, Allah says, then فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ, listen to it attentively. وَأَنصِتُوا, and be quiet and silent, Allah says. يعني when the Quran is recited, you shouldn't be distracted by anything else. You should be focusing on it. Your heart should be present. And what happens if you do that? Allah says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, so that you can attain the mercy of Allah. طيب. The ulama, they say, in the tafsir of this ayah, they say the one who listens to the Qur'an with his heart present, he listens to the Qur'an attentively, he gets the same reward as the one who recites it. He gets the same reward for every letter. Allahu Akbar. So, we say here, the one who can't recite the Qur'an, listen to the Qur'an, you get the same reward. No one has an excuse. Now we have so many records of the Quran. In your, on your phone. We have at home. In your car. Everywhere you are, you can listen to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. No excuse. Put your headphones in. Khalas. Listen to the Quran attentively and you get that great reward. You can finish the Quran constantly by listening to it. How many times? Many times. But no doubt that reciting it as well is virtuous. And it has a great effect on you as well when you recite it. And no doubt when you hear the Qur'an from other than yourself as well, when others recite it to you, it affects you too. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ, he did just that. He said to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said to him, recite the Quran to me. Abdullah Mas'ud was shocked. You see, Ya Rasulullah, أَقْرَ عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَيْكَ أُنزِلْ. How can I recite to you and the Quran was revealed to you, Ya Rasulullah? The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, he said, أُحِبُّ أَنْ أَسْمَعَهُ مِنْ غَيْرِي. He said, I love to hear it from other myself. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he started reciting Surah Al-Nisa. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. They kept going, kept going. And then he got to the ayah. فكيف إذا جئنا من كل أمة بشهيد وجئنا بك على هؤلاء شهيدا وجئنا بك على هؤلاء شهيدا. And how will it be يوم القيامة, Allah says, when we bring from every nation a witness, and we bring you, O Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام, as the witness over these people, your ummah. The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, حسبك, enough. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, I looked up, فإذا عيناه تذرفان, his eyes were crying, he was tearing up, the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. Right? Because the effect of Quran had on him when he heard it from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. One day the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he was walking in the streets of Medina, and then he went past Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, who was reciting Quran. And after he finished reciting Quran, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he raised his hand, started making dua. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he was saying, he was whispering to himself, Is'al tusma, is'al tusma, is'al tusma. He kept saying, ask more, you're being hurt. Ask more, you're being hurt. Ask for more, you are being hurt. Yani the ulama, they say that after you recite the book of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala and you make dua, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala will accept your dua because you listen to the speech of Allah, now Allah listens to what you have to say. One day the Messenger alayhi salatu wa came past another sahabi. His name was Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu arda, and he heard him recite the Quran. And Abu Musa al-Ash'ari had a beautiful voice. So the Messenger alayhi salatu was astonished by how beautiful his voice was. So the next day he saw him in the streets of Medina. He said, Ya Aba Musa, yesterday, last night, I heard you reciting the Quran. لَقَدْ أُوْتِيْتَ مِزْمَارًا مِنْ مَزَامِرِ آلِ دَوُدْ. You have been given a flute from the flute of the family of Dawud alayhi salam. Because Dawud alayhi salam had a beautiful voice. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَوُدَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا يَا جِبَالُ أَوِّبِي مَعَهُ وَالطَّيْرِ وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ. Allah says, certainly we have granted Dawood from us a fadl, a bounty, a blessing. Yani Allah granted a beautiful voice. Then Allah said, Ya Jibal. Dawood would go out to the mountains and recite the Zabur there. Then Allah said, Ya Jibal, أَوِّبِي مَعَهُ وَالطَّيِّرِ. Allah says, oh mountains, repeat after him, i.e. create an echo for him. You know, like we have microphones nowadays, sometimes when you have a nice microphone, it makes someone sound better, doesn't it? Huh? Allah told the mountains, create an echo for him, for Dawood, so his voice can reach everywhere. وَالطَّيِّرَ, and the birds to repeat after him. That's how beautiful his voice was, Dawood alayhi salam. So the Prophet alayhi salam, he said to Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, لَقَدْ أُوْتِيْتَ مِزْمَارًا مِنْ مَزَامِرِ آلِ دَوُودِ. You have been given a flute from the flutes of the family of Dawood alayhi salam, the beautiful voice, yani. Then listen to Abu Musa, he says, this is the astonishing part. He says, Ya Rasulullah, لو كنت أعلم أنك تسمعني لحبرت لك تحبيرا. If I knew, Ya Rasulullah, that you were listening to me, that was nothing, I would have beautified it even more. Subhanallah. And he said, I wasn't trying, Ya Rasulullah. If I knew you were listening, I would have tried even more. Allahu Akbar. Yani, why did Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala legislate that we recite the Quran by beautifying our voice? Because when you hear the beautiful voice, it affects the heart more.
And that's why the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, زَيِّنُ الْقُرْآنَ بِأَصْوَاتِكُمْ, beautify the Qur'an with your voices. And in another narration it says, beautify your voices with the Qur'an, i.e. the Qur'an will make your voice beautiful. Huh? Because if you recite the Qur'an with tajweed, the rules of tajweed, your voice will become beautiful. But no doubt that Allah gives some people more beautiful voices than others. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says, يَزِيدُ فِي الْخَلْقِ مَا يَشَاءُ, he increases in the creation what he wishes. Okay, in a qira'ah, which is shad. Okay, it's a qira'ah, which is shad. We don't recite it as the other 10 qira'at, but we use it for tafsir. It says, يَزِيدُ فِي الْحَلْقِ مَا يَشَاءُ, that Allah increases in the throat what he wishes. And the ulama, they say it is the beautiful voice he grants to some people, he grants a more beautiful voice than others, right? That's a ni'mah from Allah. But you can try to make your voice more beautiful by learning and implementing the ahkam of tajweed. Because that's a means to get to the heart. It's not the objective. It is a means to get to the heart. When you hear a reciter that has a beautiful voice, and perhaps you don't understand the ayat that he's reciting, does it not affect you? It affects you, right? Allah says that in the Quran. Allah nazzala ahsan al-hadith كتابا متشابها مثالي تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء ومن يضلل الله فما له من هاد. Allah revealed the best of speech, the Quran. طيب, this Quran, the best of speech, what does it do? Allah says, تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربه, the skin of those who fear Allah trembles when they hear the Quran. Not only that, ثُمَّ تَلِينُ جُلُودُهُمْ, and then their skin becomes soft, and in their body, their limbs. وَقُلُوبُهُمْ, and their hearts. إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, to the remembrance of Allah. What does that mean? When they hear the Quran, the believers who fear Allah Azza wa Jal, their hearts and their bodies, their limbs, they submit to Allah Azza wa Jal, to the will of Allah. Whatever Allah commands them to do, they do it without any hesitation. That's the effect of the Quran when they hear it. That's why a day should not go past except that we recite a portion of the Quran or we listen to the Quran, so that we're not amongst those that the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam will complain about yawm al-qiyamah to Allah Jalla fi'ala. وقال الرسول يا رب إن قوم اتخذوا هذا القرآن مهجورا. And the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he will complain to Allah عز وجل يوم القيامة about who his ummah. He will say, Ya Allah, my ummah, they have forsaken this Quran, they have abandoned this Quran that you have revealed to them. In it is mercy for them, in it is guidance for them, in it is their honor, their might, etc. And they have abandoned it, subhanAllah. Imagine the Messenger alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam complaining about the yawm al-qiyamah. La ilaha illallah. We must have a portion of the Qur'an that we recite on a daily basis. Whether it's a lot, whether it's little, it doesn't matter. Your ability, whatever you can do. Start whatever you can do. Even if it's one ayah, is better than nothing. Because the more consistent you are in doing it, it will increase gradually, inshaAllah. Just start. Start somewhere. That you recite one ayah from the book of Allah, wallahi, is better than nothing. And the Quran, whoever holds on to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal and lives by it, it is what will grant you steadfastness. Thabat. Steadfastness on the book of Allah, on the religion of Allah, I mean. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, قُلْ نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ مِنْ رَبِّكَ بِالْحَقِّ قُلْ نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ مِنْ رَبِّكَ بِالْحَقِّ لِيُثَبِّتَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لنثبت الذين آمنوا وهدى وبشرى للمحسنين. Allah says, قل say O Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام نزل روح القدس came down this Quran is جبريل عليه السلام من ربك from your Lord بالحق with the truth. Why? لِيُثَبِّتَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا to make firm and steadfast those who believe. And it's هدى guidance وبشرى and glad tidings for those who do good. The Quran about ثبات. Well, Allah says,
وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ عَلَيْهِ الْقُرْآنُ جُمْلَةً وَاحِدَةً كَذَلِكَ لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ وَرَتَّلْنَاهُ تَرْتِيلًا.
The disbelievers, they said to the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, why was the Quran revealed all at once? Why gradually? Then Allah says, كَذَلِكَ وَرَوْدِ gradually, like that. لِنُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ, to make your heart firm. And the Quran is making the heart firm. So that's what the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام did, that was saying to us. He grants us steadfastness upon the deen of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. That's the book of Allah. So the call it is that we are calling to start a new chapter in the book of Allah. A new page of the book of Allah. To have a daily portion of the Quran, and that we learn the Quran, and that we listen to the Quran, and that we act upon the Quran. Because Al-Hasan Al-Basri radiallahu anhu wa rahimahu, he says, إِنَّ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ رَأَوَ الْقُرْآنَ وَسَائِلَ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. He said, verily those who came before you, they saw the Qur'an as messages from their Lord. They recited it at night, and they acted upon it in the day. That's how they saw the Qur'an. That's how we need to view the Qur'an. We recite it, we don't want to recite it just for the sake of it, but we see it as messages from Allah Azza wa Jalla addressing us directly, and we implement it in our lives. And that's how the Salaf they were. It's reported that one of the Tabi'een, his name was Al-Ahnaf ibn Qais, rahimahullah Azza wa Jal, he was sitting in a gathering like this, and he heard a recite, قوله تعالى, لقد أنزلنا إليكم كتابا فيه ذكركم أفلا تعقلون أفلا تعقلون أفلا تعقلون. Certainly we have brought you a book, in it is your honor, Allah says, فِيهِ ذِكْرُكُمْ. Also the Mufassirun, they say that فِيهِ ذِكْرُكُمْ, it means in it is your mention, that Allah is mentioning you in the Quran. Do you not comprehend, do you not reason, Allah says. When Al-Ahnafi heard this, he said, عَلَيَّ مِنْ مُصْحَفْ, bring me the Quran. I have to recite the Quran and find where's Allah mentioning me in the Quran. That's how he saw it. So he started looking for himself in the Quran. He's looking for Ahnaf in the Quran. He came past a group of people. تَتَجَافَ جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. That their sides, they leave their beds at night, and they call upon the Lord out of love, hope and fear, worshipping Allah. And whatever we have given them, Allah says they give in charity, they give for the sake of Allah. And then he came past another group of people. كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. A little bit of night they would sleep, the rest of the night they would be in ibadah. And when the time of Fajr draws closer, they engage in istighfar, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. And then they came past another group of people.
وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةٌ.
And they give preference to themselves, they give preference to others over themselves. Even if they're in a state of poverty, they give to others, even if they need it the most. And Ahnaf, when he came past his category of people, he said, اللهم لا أجد نفسي مع هؤلاء. Oh Allah, I don't find myself here. I don't find Ahnaf here, described here. Out of humility, he said that. And then he keeps asking, Allah catch up your people.
إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ اسْتَكْبِرُونَ.
When La ilaha illallah said to his people and the disbelievers, they become arrogant. And then he keeps asking the group of people.
إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ اشْمَأَزَّتْ قُلُوبُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ.
When Allah Azza wa Jalla is mentioned alone, the hearts of those who don't believe in the Akhirah are filled with disgust. And then he keeps asking another group of people,
مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ وَلَمْ نَكُ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ وَكُنَّا نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِضِينَ وَكُنَّا نُكَذِّبُ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينَ حَتَّى أَتَانَ الْيَقِينَ.
He'll be said to the people in the hellfire, what brought you to the hellfire? They will say, we were not from those who established prayer. And we never used to feed those who were in need. And we used to indulge in idle speech with those who did so. And we used to deny the final day, Yawm al-Qiyamah, until death came to us. Al-Ahnafi, when he came past these catching of people, he said, Oh Allah, abra'u ilayka min ha'ula, I disassociate myself and I free myself from these people. I don't find myself here. The first category, he said, I don't find myself here out of humility. But he didn't drag himself that low to say that he was amongst this category. And then he came past a third category of people.
وَآخَرُونَ اعْتَرَفُوا بِذُنُوبِهِمْ خلطوا عملا صالحا وآخر سيئا عسى الله أن يتوب عليهم إن الله غفور رحيم.
Allah says, وآخر and others اعترفوا بذنوبهم. They acknowledged and admitted their sins. خَلَطُوا عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. They mix righteous deeds with evil deeds. عَسَى اللَّهُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِمْ. Allah will forgive them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah is the most merciful and the most forgiving. Al-Ahnaf, when he came past this ayah, he said, Oh Allah, I find myself here. This is Ahnaf. It's describing me. I do righteous deeds and I do evil deeds and I mix them and I ask for the forgiveness of Allah. Allah, Ya Allah, forgive me. يعني, when you recite the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, you look for yourself, your state, the state that you're in, and reflect upon the book of Allah Azza wa Jal so that you can rectify your state. That's the objective. And that's how they were, and that's why these people are successful. That's how they recited the Quran. And that's why they acted upon the Quran. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from the people of the Quran. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive our sins. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from those who the Quran intercedes for Yawm al-Qiyamah. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to have mercy upon us. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from the people of the Quran, the elite people of Allah. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from those who said to read and rise and ascend and recite like you used to recite in dunya, because your position in Jannah will be by the last verse to recite. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to grant us guidance and to increase us in guidance. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive our parents and to have mercy upon our parents. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to grant to make the Quran an evidence for us Yawm al-Qiyamah, not against us. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make the Quran that which guides us to Jannah and that which protects us from the hellfire. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from those who recite the Quran and act upon the Quran and understand the Quran and live by the Quran and call to the Quran and die acting upon the book of Allah. إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Brother, you want to take a few questions or?
No problem.
Yeah. If brothers, they have some questions, we can take a few questions because we've got time before Isha.
So I have one request for just a couple of minutes. MashaAllah, your melodious voice is very nice. And we like to hear one small chapter of our surah or something.
Khas. If there's any questions, we'll take them and then we'll end with Quran.
Inshallah.
Are there any questions? Are there any questions or you just want to hear Quran? Because we all just want to hear Quran. Na'am, tafadhal.
Where and how did you learn Quran?
Where and how did I learn the Quran? Very good question. Where did I learn the Quran? In a city which is not very far from Cambridge, I believe. It's called London. Have you heard of it? I learned the Quran in London from a young age. I don't know what's that. Alhamdulillah. Now. Ah, yes. Where do I come from? I come from London. Yes. Do you mean where I come from originally?
Yeah.
Pakistan. So,
I'm from Somalia originally. Somalia, do you know where that is?
Somalia?
Yeah. It's somewhere in the world. Huh? No. Any other questions?
No. What
motivated you to learn? What motivated me to learn? When I was young, obviously, as a child, the norm, the custom is that the parents, they take me to madrasa and learn Qur'an. So I started to learn Qur'an when I was 4 years old. So at the age of four, my parents, they took me to madrasa, they said, learn the Qur'an. At that age, I have no idea why I'm learning the Qur'an. So I'm thinking, do I have to? I just want to stay at home and play, whatever, right? So from the age of four to about the age of 10, five, 6 years, okay, I was memorizing the Qur'an, but it wasn't serious. I never took it that seriously, right? I had memorized. It took me 6 years to memorize like three juz of the Qur'an, right? When I got to the age of 10, 11 roughly, that's when I took the Qur'an seriously. Then I understood, you know, and then now I know why I learned the Qur'an. So I started to memorize the Qur'an, I started to love the Qur'an, and I started, you know, reciting it regularly to my sheikh. I would recite to him numerous days in the week. Sometimes he would be there 7 days a week. Every day I would recite some portions, some parts of the Qur'an to him, remembering, right? Because I really was motivated to finish the Qur'an, because I was going to the masjid a lot. There was a masjid that was 5 minutes walk from my house. So I used to go there when I was about 11 for every salah mostly. If I wasn't at school, for dhuhr and asr, I would be at school. But the other salahs, I'll be there. Okay? So being in that environment and being in the masjid and seeing people, the Quran and hearing the Quran, the salah and the beautiful voices that people recited, I started listening to the Quran from different reciters on YouTube. And then I would try to imitate their voices. And when I imitate their voices, then I thought, wow, you know, this is actually nice. You know, so imagine I knew the whole Qur'an, then I can imitate their voice with all the Qur'an, I thought. So that was motivated. And then I was learning Arabic at the same time, and I learned other Islamic sciences. And the more I understood the Qur'an, the more I loved it. That pushed me more and more to memorize the Qur'an and to want to learn it more and understand it more now. Now, any other questions? Yes.
The best way to increase your iman.
The best way to increase the iman is through the book of Allah. Qur'an. Listen to the Qur'an, act upon the Qur'an, do acts of obedience. Because it's obedience, righteous deeds that increase your iman. But number one, it is that the individual, he starts by seeking forgiveness. Because it is the sins that shackle you down and don't allow you to do righteous deeds. So you repent to Allah Azza wa Jal and Allah cleanses your heart, and then you'll be rejuvenated and you can do more righteous deeds, and that will increase your iman. Now. Yes, you have another question. Go ahead.
How many years did it take for you to
memorize the Quran? It took me, I was a slow one. Okay, and when I first started to memorize the Quran, I actually found it very difficult. It was very hard at the beginning. The first five juz that I memorized the Quran was the hardest thing I've done in my life, I think. Well, not really. But that time, that's what I thought. I found it so difficult. But after I finished five juz, it became very easy, to the extent that I would memorize a page in 10 minutes. That's how easy Allah made it for me. But those five juz, it took me ages, so hard, and I thought I'm never going to do this. But then it got easier, because the Quran, when you get past that first part, the first five juz, you realize the Quran, the places in the Quran are very similar. The ayat are very similar. So you come past another place and you think, wait, this is similar to a place I memorized before. So you're not really memorizing, you're just like refreshing memory and just changing whatever needs to be changed. Huh? So it got easier, alhamdulillah. And it took me about five years. To memorize the Quran. That's considered slow, because my peers and others used to memorize it in 2 years, or some of them 1 year. Now, so 2 years is the average, 5 years is considered slow, longer, but it's not about how long it takes. It's about achieving the goal. No matter how long it takes. Okay, it can take you 5 years, it can take you 10 years, it can take you longer than that, but getting to the end, that's what's important. Now, hi. How many times in a day would I do classes? My classes were mainly on the weekends. However, my sheikh used to be in the masjid on a regular basis. So after he used to come back from school, like after Maghrib, Isha time, you'd be there. So I'll prepare maybe a few pages and I'll recite to him. So the more days that he recite, the better. But sometimes I wouldn't see him the whole week. So what do? I prepare a lot and I'll see him maybe once a week. So maybe that one time in the week I recite like 10 pages to him. Right? So it depends, you know, how your teacher, your timetable is, etc. Now, any other questions?
No? We can start the question.
Yalla, we recite Quran?
Yes, please.
You can't wait. You want to record it? لا إله إلا الله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسماء بنيناها بأيد وإنا لموسعون وَالْأَرْضَ فَرَشْنَاهَا فَنِعْمَ الْمَاهِدُونَ وَمِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا زَوْجَيْنِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ إِنِّي لَكُمْ مِنْهُ نَذِيرٌ مُبِينٌ وَلَا تَجْعَلُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرَ إني لكم منه نذير مبين كذلك ما أتى الذين من قبلهم من رسول إلا قالوا ساحر أو مجنون أتواصوا به بل هم قوم طاغون فتول عنهم فما أنت بملوم وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين فإن للذين ظلموا ذنوبا مثل ذنوب أصحابهم فلا يستعجلون فويل للذين كفروا من يومهم الذي يوعدون بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الطور وكتاب مسطور في رق منشور والبيت المعمور والسقف المرفوع والبحر المسجور إن عذاب ربك لواقع ما له من دافع يوم تمور السماء مورا وتسير الجبال سيرا فويل يومئذ للمكذبين الذين هم في خوض يلعبون يوم يدعون إلى نار جهنم دعا هذه النار التي كنتم بها تكذبون أفسحر هذا أم أنتم لا تبصرون
يصلوها فاصبروا أو لا تصبروا سواء عليكم إنما تجزون ما كنتم تعملون إن المتقين في جنات ونعيم فاكهين بما آتاهم ربهم ووقاهم ربهم عذاب الجحيم كلوا واشربوا هنيئا بما كنتم تعملون متكئين على سرر مصفوفة وزوجناهم بحور عين والذين آمنوا واتبعتهم ذريتهم بإيمان ألحقنا بهم ذريتهم وما ألتناهم من عملهم من شيء كل امرئ بما كسب رهين وأمددناهم بفاكهة ولحم مما يشتهون يتنازعون فيها كأسا لا لغو فيها ولا تأثيم ويطوف عليهم غلمان لهم كأنهم لؤلؤ مكنون وأقبل بعضهم على بعض يتساءلون قالوا إنا كنا قبل في أهلنا مشفقين فمن الله علينا ووقانا عذاب السموم إنا كنا من قبل ندعوه إنه هو البر الرحيم.
جزاكم الله خير.